So desperate times call for desperate measures. Helps if you turn it on. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today we're gonna be working on a pressure washer. So I got this piece of junk here. I was using it last weekend, and let's just say I have more pressure out of my garden hose than when I hooked this thing up. Now, I rebuilt this pump several times now, and I'm just kind of tired of it. I only paid 50 bucks for it, so I'm not that upset about it. So of course, typical me, I decided to replace this pressure washer with this pressure washer. Now this is definitely a much better pressure washer. It has a Honda 9 horsepower engine on it. There's just one problem. It's also broken. So now I did get this thing off my dad, so I know the entire history of it. It was purchased back in 1997 for $1,000 at the Home Depot. Now dad did tell me that he used this thing for a couple years and then it broke on him, and it's been sitting ever since, which means it's been sitting for over 20 years. Now let's start getting into what we know is wrong with this thing. So the gas in this tank has been sitting in there for over 20 years and that's just not good. So that gas has got to go. We're gonna be changing the oil because that's definitely gonna need done. And something tells me we're probably gonna need a air filter in this thing. I don't know. And the last thing on this engine is we'll change out that spark plug. Now, if we come over to the pump and look in the sight window, that oil is extremely milky, meaning water's been getting in here. Now, I have no idea how the water got in here. It could be a bad seal. It could be just condensation or water getting in here on its own. So I'm not gonna worry about it. I'm gonna replace the oil. If it keeps getting milky, I know we have a bad seal. If it stays nice and fresh, we're good to go. Now, the last issue that I know that's wrong with this thing is this unloader bolt is completely snapped off. You can see the end of it here. I did purchase some new ones to replace this old one, but I am gonna have to extract the piece that's broken off in there. I'm fairly confident I can do so, but we're gonna have to see how that goes. All right, so now you know everything that I know is wrong with this thing. We're gonna go ahead and remove the pump from the engine. I wanna get this engine started, but I don't want the pump running when I do. I wanna get the engine all dialed in, and then we'll move on to working on the pump. So we're gonna separate those two pieces. So desperate times call for desperate measures. There was not a set screw in here, so I started pulling this out. I got it as far as I could with the chisels. Now I got a pry bar back there and I got this ratchet strap pulling on this whole thing. And then I'm gonna try to pry it out now, but this is getting a little wild, but I'm hoping we'll get it. Man, that was a pain, but that pump is officially off. Now I'm gonna start with something hopefully easy and replace this air filter. It definitely didn't hurt anything, but that foam pre-filter is gone. While I got this area opened up, I am gonna replace the spark plug. Also, while we got access to everything, I got a little more room in here to look at this fuel line. I am gonna drain this tank. I think I'm gonna completely unbolt the tank, try to disconnect this fuel line down here, and then drain all that fuel out. All that gas is drained, so we are good to go. The last thing I want to do before I start throwing everything back together is take this off. I believe Honda calls it the sediment bowl, but it's just like the float bowl. So I'm gonna take this off and see how much crap we got in it, and that'll just give us a good idea of what kind of condition the carburetor's in. Here's the float bowl completely dry, and you can see all that crap just floating around in there. So all that would have got sucked through the carburetor eventually, so I'm glad I'm cleaning this out now. I'm gonna clean it out. Now I'm gonna throw it back on the carburetor. Now there's a good chance the rest of the carburetor is gonna be kind of in this condition, but we're just gonna run it and see what happens. It's a Honda, it should be all right. So we've got all the loose stuff out. The rest of that is just corrosion, so it's gonna be what it is. Time to get everything back on. Now I did just think of this, but I think this is a filter on the bottom of the fuel tank, so I'm gonna take this off and see how it looks. I may be replacing that, but I did not order one, so that would have to be in the future. But I do wanna see what kind of condition that's in. Surprisingly, that filter looked really good, so this fuel tank is going back on the mode. All right, so that does it for the engine. So we're just gonna scoot this thing away from the water we spilled on the ground, and then we're gonna gas it up, check for leaks, and try to fire it up.
Oh yeah, and I'm gonna make sure it has oil in it. That seems kind of important. All right, so it's got plenty of oil.
Now, if it does fire it up, I'm gonna let it run for a while, let it get warmed up, so that way we can get this oil warmed up and then we'll get that changed out.
That would help.
Helps if you turn it on. All right, so this thing just fired right up. As soon as I remembered to turn that on switch, it just kicked right on. That was my own stupidity. Actually, first pull once I had the on switch on. I also didn't remove the keyway, so I was waiting for that to launch into outer space. That didn't happen. Very happy about that because I don't have another one to replace it with. And I'm extremely pumped because worst case scenario, I got that engine running. So if I can't get the pump working, I just have a spare motor for the go-kart. This engine has been fired up for around 5 minutes or so, got it nice and warm, so I'm gonna go ahead and drain the oil. And I would like to take this time to thank the engineers at, I don't know how to pronounce this, Devilbiss, you guys will make fun of me no matter what. But I'd like to thank the engineers for taking the time to line up this drain plug with this slot in the frame. It's not lined up, that's gonna make a mess. We're just gonna have to pray for the best. I think it's just gonna get all over the driveway no matter what I do. We'll just encourage that oil to not go everywhere. That's lovely. We got oil going down the hole. We got oil running down the back. We got oil running underneath my rag. I'm just gonna go ahead and get the drain plug back in. And all this oil you see down here, I think that's just, we're gonna call it rust prevention. Man, that'll ruin your day. Oh my God. We can now fill this thing up with oil, and we can basically fill it up till we start to see it coming up in this area. This is your fill line, so as long as it's up in this neck area here, it'll read on your dipstick and you'll be good to go. Now this thing should take around 1.2 quarts of oil, so we shouldn't have too much out of this quart and it should be full. We can see the oil in there, so we don't really have to check it with the dipstick, but just to be 100% sure, we'll stick that dipstick in there and you can see that oil right on there. All right, so we got that engine running. Now we got to get this pump up and running. This is a triplex pump, so if you don't know how they work, this flange here connects to the engine. There's a little drive shaft that connects to a camshaft in here. That camshaft connects to three connecting rods, and then those connecting rods are moving these valves here. You got three inlets, three outlets. So you got your water inlet that comes in here, and this is your low pressure circuit. As it moves up through the pump, you have your high pressure circuit, and then it'll be pushed out this tip here into your nozzle. Now this part here is called your unloader. So this unloader, what it does is when you're actually pulling down that trigger, it's allowing that water to flow out the nozzle of your gun. But the second you let off that trigger, now it's closing that valve because it builds up so much pressure, and it's recirculating that high pressure water back down into this low pressure system, and it just circulates that water through your pump. Otherwise, it would just build up so much pressure, it'd blow out your hoses, and it would not be a good thing. And in our case, our unloader, it connects here and here. So I believe I can remove this screw here and pull this whole unloader out. And hopefully that'll give me enough access into this broken bolt here. It's just an unloader bolt, and we'll be able to get that out and put our new one in. Now these two housings were split apart, so I do need to check the O-rings in there, but I'm not gonna worry about that until I can get this bolt out. If I can't get this bolt out, we're gonna have to replace this entire pump because it's just not worth it to replace this one component. I didn't want to have to resort to the impact, but we're going to get this off one way or another. One way to get it off. Well, this is not a good start. Now we got two broken bolts we get to deal with, but hopefully we'll be able to pull this unloader off. Here's what those two bolts are supposed to look like. You can see there are holes through them, and that's why they're so weak. There's the little guy, and there's the big guy. PB Blaster is going to be our best friend today. Got some big channel locks here. I do not think I'll be able to move it. Well guys, I didn't want to have to do it, but we have resorted to welding a nut onto the end of this thing. I'm hoping it'll work. We'll find out. Just broke off that center. Did not work. Alrighty guys, so I'm admitting defeat. I was not able to get this out. I tried grinding some flat spots, wrenching on them. I tried welding a nut on, that didn't work. I tried drilling them out and stuffing an easy out in there. That didn't work. So I'm just gonna give up on the thing. And just out of curiosity, I wanted to see how decent these valves were. And they're pretty chewed up, so they would have had to be replaced anyways. It might have ran for a little bit, but I don't think it would have ran for too long. Today wasn't a complete waste though. We got a good motor. So I'm gonna get a pump for this thing and we'll be back.
I'm back and I bought some things.
So I went ahead and I purchased an hour meter because I'm gonna start maintaining this thing, and both that GX270 and the new pump require the oil to be changed every 100 hours. So now I can keep track of that. And I also bumped up to a much higher rated hose. This one's rated for 5,000 PSI. The pump's gonna be putting out 3,800, which exceeds the old hoses. So just to be safe, I upgraded the hose and also got a quick connect fitting for my gun. Let's get this hour meter on, then I'll be showing you guys what pump I got and I'll be telling you exactly why I went with that one. I do plan on mounting this thing right up in here. I think it's a pretty decent spot. I can see it very easily and it'll keep it away from the heat of the engine. And then I'm just gonna run that wire out the back down this little channel and across to this spark plug wire. So to connect the wire to the hour meter, you just feed it through the back. Then you're gonna feed this wire back in through the front until it bottoms out, just like so. And then you can hold this one in and it should look something like that. Now I ran that wire down the back of this tube and I'm gonna run it across here to the spark plug wire. And I'm gonna wrap it around 4 or 5 times and then zip tie it back on itself. Now before I cut this excess wire off, I'm gonna fire up this engine and make sure that that hour meter is working. Now we know everything is good because once we fired up that engine, that little hourglass symbol started flashing. That just means your engine is chooching. So then I took it outside and just let it run for a little bit and I put 0.1 hours on this engine already. So we are
good to go.
I just want to mention that I will be putting all the parts that I'm using in this video down in the description below. And you're probably wondering what pump I bought for this thing. And there it is. So I will flip that over so you guys can read it. But I went with the AAA Triplex pump, part number 90038. Now this pump can be used on the Honda GX270, which is why I got it, and it's an upgrade. This is a 3,500 PSI pump that pumps out 3.5 gallons per minute, as opposed to our original pump, which was a 3,000 PSI 3 gallon per minute pump. Now this AAA pump is made by Simpson Cleaning, so it is just part of the Simpson brand, and it is on pressure washers all over. Now I was debating between this and a cat pump. Cat pumps are extremely nice, extremely expensive, and they last forever. But I'm just a home gamer, so I can buy two of these pumps for one cat, so this is what I went with. Now, this pump did come with all the mounting hardware, and it even came with the key, which is pretty awesome, because we could have launched that other one and been just fine. It came with the injection hose, and it has the oil already in here, so it is ready to go. All we have to do is bolt it up. I tried to clean up this shaft as best as I could with Scotch-Brite. I'm now gonna throw a ton of anti-seize on it. That way, if that new pump decides to go, I'll be able to get it off a little bit easier than that last one. That was a pain. I'm gonna tighten these four bolts in a star pattern and they're gonna get tightened down to 25 to 27 foot-pounds. And the very last thing we need to do is remove this red cap and replace it with this breather cap. Now before I actually fire this thing up, I got the water running through it, just running through that pump. It'll prime it and just make sure that it's nice and lubricated and getting all that dirt and stuff out of there before we attach our nozzle. And if you're wondering why I'm all bundled up, it was snowing out earlier today.